is Ben Lang Henricks with a mini lesson called Shadows and Shadow Play with GIMP 2.8. In this, I'm going to show you how to take a cutout figure and put it in a scene, copy and paste it into here, and then we're going to create a shadow. And what we're going to do that is we're going to position her where we want her, label the layers, but now we're going to copy the figure, that layer. Then we will isolate it, show just the shadow. Now we're going to do render clouds and difference clouds. And what that's going to do is it's going to give a kind of black and white view, but something with some complexity. It makes the shadow look better. And then I'm going to darken it, so it's mostly like a shadow. It's in the same position she is, so first we're going to move it a little bit, because the shadow is going to be behind her. We can move it around depending on where we want the angle of the light to come from. Play with the shadow itself after we get it in the right position. Now that we're happy with where it is, we're going to change the mode to grain merge so that you can see the behind. And it's still a little too dark, so you can just change the opacity so that you can see the shadow as dark as you want it to be. And that's how you make a shadow. It's that simple. But now what if we wanted to play with the shadow, taking another of the same figure, but in a different position? I'm going to paste that image, that shadow in. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to make an animated GIF with a few different transitions from the one shadow to the other, so that it looks like the shadow is leaning back and stretching while the person doesn't move. Kind of a cinemagraph. I'm going to put her at a little bit of an angle, a little bit further away, so that it looks like there's a movement. Play with it a little bit more, get it where we want it. Then what we're going to need to do is we're going to need to make several transitions between the different shadows so that it looks like there's an animation almost. What we'll do is we'll copy the figures, the individual ones, and we'll start manipulating each individual shadow. So there are the two. We're going to start with the first shadow and make a copy of it and then change that. And then we can work either from that shadow or we can work back from the other shadow. I'm going to do a little bit of both, and then try to move the shadows so that they are a sequence. In this one, I'm actually shifting the arms a little bit. So once I've got a series of shadows where I want them to be, I'm going to copy the background multiple times and merge down each one of the shadows onto a background. And then I copy the figure and do the same thing. Basically merge down the figure on top of each one. So now you watch, I'm going to merge down. One by one, I'll merge down each of the backgrounds. Then I'll go to the figure, and I'll make several copies of that, one for each layer. And then I'll shift them down and merge those as well. What that does is it gives us identical layers, except for the shadow. And this is what we use in GIMP to make an animated GIF, is just a series of layers. So now I can go to Animation and Optimize for GIF. Since most of the image is exactly the same, I don't need it to show. I just need a little tiny bit of difference between each one, which makes it smaller. You'll notice that each layer now has 100 milliseconds as its time, so it's a very, very fast shadow, which is not what we want. We want something more subtle than that. So I'll go and edit the layer attributes for each one and change the first one to be a longer time, and then each of the others to be about a quarter second. So that it's not as fast, but it looks like there's a pause before she starts stretching, and maybe a little bit, half a second, when she's all the way stretched out. Once we go ahead and do that, we can try the animation again, and we'll do a playback. And now you see, you watch for a moment, and then the shadow stretches out. If she's stretching out, that's the effect we're going for. So thank you very much for watching, and see our other videos.